नाउ क्वेश्चन इज अ प्लेयर थ्रोज अ बॉल अपवर्ड्स विथ एन इनिशियल स्पीड राइट 29.4 मीटर सेकेंड इनवर्स. वॉट इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ एक्सेलेरेशन ड्यूरिंग द अपवर्ड मोशन ऑफ अ बॉल. सो सी हियर डायरेक्शन ऑफ एक्सेलेरेशन ड्यूरिंग अपवर्ड मोशन ऑफ अ बॉल इट विल डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन बिकॉज ऑलवेज acceleration due to gravity always will be downward direction. Then B, what are the velocity and acceleration of the ball at the highest point of its motion? So always at the highest point velocity will be zero and acceleration remains constant, it is 9.8 meter second inverse throughout the journey. Choose the x is equal to 0 meter and t is equal to 0 second to be the location and time of the ball at its highest point vertically downward direction to be the positive direction of x-axis and give the sign of position. So see how is the position. Position is always greater than 0 for up and down also, both x will be x greater than 0. Then velocity. Now velocity will be less than zero when it is going upward, because whenever any object is going upward velocity decreases because of gravitational acceleration is downward. So here in particular whenever object moving upward direction acceleration and velocity both are opposite, that's why velocity will be decreasing. But when it is moving downward velocity will be increasing, right? So v greater than 0 when object is moving downward direction. And then the last acceleration always greater than 0, either it is moving up or down throughout the journey, it is always greater than 0, right? So and the last one, to what height does the ball rise and after how long does the ball return to the player's hands? Okay, so here we are having two different data. That first data is u is equal to 29.4 and second is g. Now we know that at maximum height any velocity is zero, so we can put the formula, third equation of motion, v square minus u square is equal to 2gs, right? V zero 29.4 square is equal to 2 into 9.8 into s, right? Now here 29.4, right, that we have to calculate. So see here 29.4 into 29.4, right? So we will get 864. So minus 864.36 is equal to 2 into 9.8, so that will be 19.6 into s, right? So now s is equal to this 864.36 by 19.6, right? So we will get 44.1. so s is equal to 44.1 meter. That is the height of the ball rise, right? So v is equal to 0, so we have both values, right? First s and yes, how long does, so time that we have to find. So first equation of motion, v is equal to u plus at. v is 0, what is u? U is 29.4 and plus 9.8 into s, right? Here negative sign will be there because of this is the journey, right? Acceleration and velocity are opposite, that's why I have to write minus 9.8. now s is equal to 29.4 upon 9.8, so 29.4, right, 29.4 upon 9.8 will be 3. So time taken to reach the maximum height is 3 seconds. And see how does the ball return to the player's hand. So here journey are of two time, this is only for to reach the maximum height, but the whole journey will be completed in 6 seconds by throwing up and it returning back to the player's hand. 6 seconds it takes to whole complete the journey.